Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is episode 3 of ISUXDIX Heart Cinema, being recorded July 6th, this year of our Lord, 2 Oceans 12. I'm Scott Henson. To my left, your right, is Drew Sarian. Across from me, Kelly Summers. And across from me also, friend of the show, Justin Chu, making his first appearance after 2 conspicuous no-shows. Christopher Lambert, still MIA. We hope to have him on episode 4. MIA, also still MIA. So we're going to... Okay, first of all, we're trying something radically different. We are recording this directly to MP3 instead of AMR as in episode 1 or 3GP as in episode 2. So hopefully our 90-minute audio file won't be 3 megabytes like it was last time. So maybe...
move
maybe you'll be able to hear us pronounce the letters P and S and F, and they'll sound different. So hopefully this is a step in the right direction before we purchase our studio. Format-wise, we're going to go a little different because Kelly is on a tight schedule where he needs to go eat something. So we are going to jump right into games.
You have no idea how strict food is.
He's also on a tight diet of moose meat. Only the best quality moose meat from Mr. Summers.
The finest. Sterling Silver, Omaha moose meat. So we're going right to a round of games with Kelly. Then Kelly will be summarily dismissed. And then we will have our chitty chat and then play a second unprecedented round of games. All right?
Yay!
Good. Drew's going to host this game. I'm going to stop talking so much.
Because I'm a selfish jerk.
Drew's a selfish jerk. This has been well established in the first 2 episodes.
Seconded.
Seconded to my far right.
That's your close right. Kelly's your far right.
Drew, please don't give away our show business secrets. So Drew's going to host. We're going to open with a round of build a title, a very high stakes game to determine who goes first in the second game, the Leonard Maltin game. Drew, I am handing it over to you.
Well, thank you, Scott. We'll get this going real fast here. The build title, the first category, the first movie is Darkness Falls. So it's got to end with darkness or dark and start with falls or alls. And I'm going to give it to Chewie because this is his first appearance on the show. So, Justin Chu.
I feel like this is charity.
Take it away.
But that's fine.
Hello, world. My first contribution to this, what hopes to be a long-standing series, is going to be Alone in the Darkness Falls.
I thought you might go that way.
I'm glad you did.
Are we going clockwise?
We're going to you. We'll go Chewie to you.
Home Alone in the Darkness Falls.
That's to you, Kelly, so it's got to end with home, or start with falls, or alls.
Fly away home, alone in the darkness. Alone in darkness falls.
Starring a woman who Scott would put his wiener in.
Which one?
Is Anna Paquin not in that movie?
It's Jeff Daniels.
It's Anna Paquin, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's Anna Paquin. Anna Paquin and some geese.
Some geese, yeah. You'd put your wiener in Anna Paquin, would you not?
And some geese.
And some geese. A gaggle.
I make the geese gaggle, all right.
At face value, and I do mean face value because of those weird teeth she's got, I wouldn't put my wiener in Anna Paquin, but I do have a strict I would fuck everyone on True Blood policy. So she's in.
Man or woman?
You've seen the men on that show, right?
Are we talking Kurt gorgeous. Anna or are we talking the Piano Anna?
We're talking Piano Anna.
All right.
Piano, as it were.
I suppose it's to me, then.
It is back to Justin, and it has to end with fly. Can't be the fly. Oh. That ends the game. Oh. Or start
the game.
Start with falls.
You may not, because if we let you say the fly, guess what I can say? The fly. We get caught in an infinite loop.
The fly.
And society crumbles.
That's fine. No, I.
Look, the nerd guy in Cabin in the Woods wanted society to crumble, and what did he get? He got it. He got smashed by
fish. Spoilers! No spoilers on that movie.
He got smashed.
People still haven't seen it.
They've had time.
I don't care. That's...
It was Godzilla.
It's fucking
great. He got smashed by Godzilla.
Okay. Ends with fly, starts with falls or alls?
M. Butterfly, away home, and alone in the dark, in the falls.
What?
Fuck.
M. Butterfly?
You.
I am...
John Lone is very handsome, for the record.
I am unfamiliar of this movie.
Yeah.
It is an adaptation of Madame Butterfly.
Yeah.
Okay.
I can confirm, okay. Unfortunately. But the end in
M. Or start with alls. Falls.
Well, he...
You fools. You're falling right into my trap. Them, butterfly. Away home, alone, in the darkness falls. Suck my dick.
Which okay, so that doesn't help because now it has to end in the or them.
It can't even really end in the. Well, we don't need to have this conversation because guess what? Nothing ends in the.
Okay, yeah. So Kelly, it's got to start with all falls or alls or end in them.
Good luck, asshole.
Remember to throw this glass at you.
Is it a glass or plastic?
Glass.
Then we will table that for now.
All right.
Bank that for later. It'll be well used.
I'll leave that here for you. You can throw it at him later.
Oh, it'll be thrown.
I will say something toward it.
Yes, you will.
Oh, you got podcast silence. That's always good.
Yep.
Ah.
It's what we in the business refer to as audio gold.
Nothing's coming to mind?
Not really.
Okay, Kelly, you're up. Back to Justin.
Wow. That sucks.
Tough crowd.
With
Colin. Them or falls.
Can we get Colin to come on the show?
We'll try
for Colin. If we can get him out of his hole.
Yeah, get him out of his hole writing his manifesto, pretending he's still hosting Weekend Update.
Oh, I thought you meant Colin Mockery.
No, I would prefer we don't have him on the show.
How about Ryan Stiles?
Stiles is okay. Okay, he's like a C minus.
How would Greg prove?
Okay, I feel like you're stalling for time here, Justin.
I feel like you're naming everyone you know from Who's Line Is It Anyway.
Yes,
you lose. Scott, you win.
Give me a chance.
He was pretty invested in the Who's Line stuff,
okay,
so we'll give him a
second. No more Who's Line.
Think about the movie, even though he's got nothing.
Also, just for reference, I wrote your name down as Big China on this piece of paper.
That's all right. I feel like it's a good...
China! They call me Big China!
Big China, comma, Little Trouble in.
Wait, that's them, though.
Them apples, comma, how do you like them?
That is three times now that that's been used.
Well, when it stops being funny, we'll stop. So, at the earliest, episode 4.
Okay.
You know nothing. What? This is far too difficult.
Okay. I thought you were about to get really mad. You know what? This is bullshit. And I'm out of here. I feel
Scott, close it off.
You're
going to get like a half point.
Happy to close it off with them... Butterfly away, home alone, and the darkness falls well that ends well. Or
was that a movie?
Falls fair in love and war. I feel like one of those has to be a movie. Those are just sayings.
those, I think those...
One of them's gotta be.
Did they not try and use that on Doug, though, and then it was proven that it wasn't... Graham tried to use it, and it wasn't one of them.
I'm an international pad.
I'm consulting it's an information pad.
That's right, international pad.
Don't be ridiculous. This is local. This is locally grown.
Organically sourced information pad?
Yeah.
I wanted to say Alls in the family.
television show.
Be wrong.
A television show and their own words.
Don't throw that glass at me.
Rwanda Hotel.
Rwanda Hotel.
That would have been good if it was
if it was the name of a movie. Confirmed.
Rwanda Hotel for Dogs.
You know, we're not doing that. But that
it's
would work.
Again,
Rwanda, that would work if Rwanda Hotel was the name of a movie. Now,
are we still recording?
Yeah, it just turns off sometimes.
The screen goes off. It's
conserving energy. It's being green for a phone.
There is no All's Well That Ends Well, and there is no All's Fair in Love and War.
Oh,
there,
so you fucking suck.
There is some random piece of shit movie from 1989 just called All's Fair, starring George Segal.
That doesn't
count. That nobody's heard of.
Well, you wouldn't have won because you didn't know it, so give me the goddamn information bad.
What do you mean I wouldn't have won? I still did win. I just was trying to win twice like a smart guy.
No, nope. You're not Kelly. Only Kelly can win twice. Also, why did you close the app? I need it. You dang.
I feel whenever I'm done with something, even if the next person needs it, I close it. I feel like it's iPad etiquette.
Oh, shit. Robert Carradine was in that movie. One of the Carradine dynasty. Okay, so it's the Scott... Point three, Scott, would you like Flight of the Phoenix, which is a movie with either Joaquin or River Phoenix in it?
Okay.
You can have It's the End of the World as We Know It and I Feel Fine, which are disaster movies. And
that one fucked me last time.
Really?
And let's go. Really? I like this category. I don't know that anybody's going to pick it. But it's I'm Running Man, which is movies where somebody runs for president.
Drew, if you like it, I'm going to pick it. I'm Running Man.
Hey, Mr. Scott, would you like 2008, 2003, or 2006?
All reasonable years. Let's go 03. Who ran for president in 03? George W. Bush was approaching his second term.
That's not what the category is.
Was that a movie?
Anyways, okay, so Leonard gives this movie 2.5 stars, I think is extremely generous.
Okay.
If I'd taken a stab at the previous game, I would have gotten something.
What was your stab?
Something about the word Anthem.
The main star is the whole show here, and he's on top of his game. The filmmaking is sloppy, as is the story development, but the director, co-writer, and star deliver the laughs.
What year was this?
Is he
the main actor is also the director and co-writer.
Okay.
And, yeah, 2.5 stars, 2003. And it's got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13 names.
Start with 11.
11 to Kelly.
-1.
Whoa.
Confidence.
Okay, Justin, chew to you. That is -1 from
me. Name it immediately.
Okay, Kelly, you got to name the movie and number one actor, and I am going to not say anything if you're wrong until you say it.
Yeah, I hope I have the movie right.
Head of State, Chris Rock. Kelly Summers with 1 point.
Wow!
Pull these fucking things out, and it's just...
You know why I knew it was
wrong with you?
You know why?
Infuriating.
Because I'm thinking...
Your love of the African-American?
Well, I do love them. But 2003, I'm thinking, running for president. I'm like, 2003. That seems so familiar. And then all of a sudden, a Battle Royale TNA popped in my head, and I'm like, holy shit, that was that stupid Chris Rock movie where he was trying to be president.
Oh my god. The worst thing that happened.
Yeah, as much Rain Man over here.
As much as I hate TNA, I have to give him a shout out for giving me that point.
Wow, okay, so that means
don't treat Dixie Carter.
Kelly Summers, 1 point on the board, and since Chewie told you to name it, it goes Scott to Justin.
Yeah.
So, Scott, now, would you like In the Line of Fire, which is a movie where somebody dies by burning alive?
I like it.
Let's go with Wayans World, a movie with the Wayans family dynasty.
All of them? A movie with all
one,
of them in it?
One or more or all.
I feel like it should be two or more, but all right.
And I will say, let's go with... You know what? Iron Lady movies with a female robot.
What? Let's do... despite my better judgment, Wayne's World.
Okay, would you like...
crowd pleaser.
Again, this is more mostly to appease Kelly's love of the African-American.
Would you like 1996?
Maybe.
1996? Or 1991?
Oh, I was really hoping
for... I wished I had three 96s, but I didn't.
91.
91. Interesting decision.
I'm an interesting man.
I apparently spelled that wrong. Okay, Leonard gives it 2 stars. Reasonable. Let's see.
Try not to put the iPad directly between your voice and the microphone.
I'll read it next to my face.
Okay.
Ooh, man, there is not a whole lot I can read here. More of the same from Lethal Weapon screenwriter Shane Black. Violent even by this genre standards, but zippy enough to make it an okay view.
Not what I thought
it
was.
2, 4, 6, 8 names.
Eight.
Not true. Big China, you're 8.
Had 2 movies in mind, that is clearly not either of them.
7.
6.
5.
4.
Name it. Ooh, 4 names.
I feel like I'm rarely involved in the points-getting opportunities.
Start telling people to name it, then.
But I get to pick every category, that's so
true.
It's very exciting.
That is true. Okay, so it is... Sorry, Chewie's naming it?
Chewie's naming it.
Okay,
I hope he names it right.
It is...
I have an idea, but...
4 names.
But I don't think I have the name right in my head right now.
Okay, you got Bruce McGill.
This isn't going to help me.
Halle Berry.
She's a person.
Yeah.
Danielle Harris. And Taylor Negron.
I know that name.
Top 2 would help you, obviously.
Wayne's 1, Wayne's 2.
2 stars, 1991. It's screenwriter of Lethal Weapon. It's violent. But it's zippy enough to make it an okay view.
It had a movie in my head.
Halle Berry, very low on the bill, so she must have been relatively new to the...
I was 91, so...
Yeah. Pretty young, too.
She hadn't got destroyed Billy by Billy Bob yet.
Yeah.
Monster's Balls, good movie.
That was directed at you.
Try not to give Kelly another point.
Yeah, Kelly's goddamn good at this game.
No, I'm not.
You are a butthole wrecker. That might be that might be because you have a monster dick, but...
Who has wrecked more buttholes, Kelly or Billy Bob Thornton?
Kelly, obviously.
Only because Billy Bob wrecked one over and over again.
All right.
Angelina Jolie.
Are you thinking hard?
Don't be a menace to South Central or drink your juice in the hood.
Oh, no. I wish it was that movie. I have never seen that movie. I will go off the cast list. Noble Willingham, Chelsea Field, Damon Wayans, Bruce Willis.
Oh, shit.
What the hell's Willis Wayans?
Yeah.
Fucking Rain Man over
for
here.
For the extra point. Although
no, I know a movie you're talking about, but I don't know.
It is The Last Boy Scout.
Yeah.
I was...
When we're going Wayans 91, I'm going either Don't Be a Menace or the other one that's the same thing. I'm going to get you, sucker.
Oh, yeah. That one was much later. That was
never late. That was later? Okay, yeah.
I don't see a lot of Wayans movies that aren't Little Man or Wayne Chick.
A little bit later, like 93, 94, wasn't it?
It's close. Like, you get, I don't know...
And 91 felt a bit early for it.
Yeah, but that's what I had in my head.
That's the only one I could think
and
of.
Then, but then he's talking violence. I'm like, oh, it's not a comedy. Shit, yeah. I have no idea then. Mm. And I didn't.
All right. Well, Kelly, almost running away with this one.
We gotta stop him.
Let's, okay, no. So it's back to Scott. Ready, and no. It is Scott to Kelly this time. So let's go with All Bombs, which is a movie Leonard gave a bomb to.
Okay.
well... What did we change the Merkin category to? Merkin...
Jerkin' Your Merkin?
Jerkin' Your Merkin, that's what it was. Jerkin' Your Merkin, which is... A Merkin is a wig for your pubic area that female actresses wear in movies when they don't have bushes and they're supposed to. So this is a movie where somebody wears a Merkin.
It is very unfortunately
a thing.
It is a thing. It is a
hot.
It is a vagina wig.
God, what, this is
holy. Well, you know what, Kelly? Sometimes when people do a little bit too much electrolysis down there, they can't grow it back.
Oh, Hollywood, you're so gross.
Jerking your merkin. What was the other one I said?
Think of any movies
all bombs. And,
except for, like, bad.
I'm going to dig back into the back cab, back wall here.
Yeah.
Let's go. I did not see that coming. Movies featuring Nazis.
I'm thinking I should have been paying more attention to these options.
Oh my! Really? Nazis, all bombs, or Merkin?
I'm not happy with any of these, but let's go Nazis.
I wanted to see what the Merkin movies were.
No Merkin movies.
That's gross.
I feel like too many of these would give away what they are, so I'm just going to pick one.
You son of a bitch.
He did that last time, didn't he?
At his discretion. It was fucking...
No, I did the whole time.
Why are you cheating so much?
No, I'm not even playing.
Look, Dungeon Master.
Okay, I will go with...
Are you showing off your Merkin?
Kelly doesn't need a Merkin. He's all natural.
Most Merkins are made from Kelly.
Yeah. Okay, this movie is from 2004.
Like, somewhere Sharon Stone is wearing a piece of Kelly right now.
Man. I wouldn't give to be that Merkin.
Hey, Sharon Stone. She's a handsome lady.
She is handsome, especially in Spear.
Oh, that short haircut.
Got me all hot and bothered now.
Looking fine. That 10-year-old boy
haircut. Okay. Favorite feature. All right. Yeah. This movie is from 2004. It is 3 stars. Enough effects and imaginative ideas for at least 2 movies stuffed into one. Okay.
Sorry, what year was this?
2004.
This is the Nazi category?
Yeah.
Director's cut runs 145 minutes. That's really all I can say without giving it away.
Of course. I like to time my movies.
2, 4, 6, 8, 9 names.
And what was the first thing you read?
That it is enough effects and imaginative ideas for at least 2 movies stuffed into one. And it's, 3 stars, 2004, 9 actors, is that what I said? 9? Yeah.
Okay. Let's go 8. Kelly.
Kelly told Chewie to name it, so yeah, it's back to Kelly.
Nazis in 04.
-1.
Words out of my mouth were, if you're going to say -1, I'm going to lunge across this table and punch you in the chest.
You're ruining the magic.
Do it!
But here's the thing, I could be wrong, right?
Okay,
I won't be wrong, because... Because then you get the point.
Exactly.
Should I steal a point and give it to you?
I feel like that's poor form, but I'm not going to say no. Do you think he knows it?
Look, he's fucking Rain Man.
He's Rain Man.
He's pulled stuff out of his ass before.
But I...
Remember when he got Dante's Peak?
I remember when he got Dante's Peak.
I could be wrong, though.
I guess he could be wrong.
It might even have the year mixed up.
I don't know.
Hope so. You do have a weird concept of time. Not weirder than my mom, who was pretty sure that Scent of a Woman was made in the 60s.
That's reasonable.
That good-looking Chris O'Donnell.
Yeah. I'm like, well... How old is Al Pacino now? And she's like, I don't know, 60-something. How old was he then? 40-something. Well, Mom.
That's some great math.
I wonder if Al
Pacino is like, he's like leap year. He only has a birthday every 4 years.
Mom transcends time, whatever, no big deal.
Yes, my mom, as a timeless being, has difficulty keeping track of the millennia that she's been alive.
So she's 21 and older.
Yes.
Bugs. Telling us outside, there's always bugs.
I know, I don't like this. Is our first outside recording. Yeah. Very exciting.
Drew's Sundeck. Alright.
Name it. Kelly. Oh,
boy.
May I preface this by saying that I hate you?
But you don't understand. I could be wrong.
2004, 3 stars, and.
You could also not be wrong.
I'm not going to say it until you tell me.
I'm pretty sure I'm wrong now that I think about it.
I would
say.
I want to hear it.
Hellboy Ron Perlman.
Telly just swept the board!
Oh, I hate Telly.
Telly just swept the board!
I hate him!
He just shit on your chest and he peed in your dinner.
Why would you pee in my dinner? I at least get the.
Well, he can eat it, it's just all the pee. Used
up. After I clean up, I get a decent meal. That's all I know.
God damn it, Kelly.
Kelly's making
I still don't have to clean up, though.
Kelly's making muscle poses for those of you at home.
We're playing a five.
I am okay with this, and I'm okay with someone making a comeback.
That literally took 15 minutes for Kelly to run the board.
I'm full of hate right now. I'm so mad.
Drew, you need to pick better movies than Kelly.
No, it's not my fault. You guys don't know what he would... He just got lucky. He didn't
what,
name
it's not
last...
your fault we don't know more than Rain Man? Guess who knows more than Rain
he
Man?
He didn't name no last one. Boy Scout. You it's just true. Nobody else knew what it was.
This is too damn hard.
I'd like to take this opportunity to retire as undefeated champion.
Summers is the worst.
All right, well, since Kelly's out and you two are still here with 0 points, let's keep playing.
All right. Bastard!
All right, Kelly, say goodbye to the lovely viewers. Wave goodbye. Blow them kisses.
Both horrible audio. So do something besides that.
Fart.
Don't.
I'm not gonna fart.
Ruffle up your shirt a little. I hope people can hear that.
Yeah, that'll play well on the mic.
All right. Anything you want to say? Yeah, you can name a shithead if you want while you're leaving now.
You can plug anything you want and name a shithead.
What do I want to plug?
Did I joke about plugging your mom last time?
Yeah.
It was like I did.
It's not funny this time either.
Justin seemed to find that
this is the first time I've ever heard it.
Exactly, see? Every time we have someone new, I get to make the joke.
I'm a fan of the show, but I'm not a fan of the show.
I'm going to plug The Hunter, which I just saw. So
Willem Dafoe versus Tasmanian Tigers.
It's okay.
No spoilers.
I haven't
watched it yet.
Once you watch it, we'll discuss it.
Okay, it'll be a review movie.
And to make Scott even more mad, my shithead's going to be me for sweeping the game.
I agree.
The mother's going to get you.
Self-named shithead, not bad. Not bad.
Swarmed by insects on your way out.
Well, looks like you might be.
I'm going to go through the dark alley.
But when I leave,
hey,
I just see Kelly's skeleton.
Category somewhere.
Oh, I just know it's my skeleton.
Not the bees. Okay, if I leave shortly and there's a skeleton, I'm going to assume it's
you.
I find it hard to believe there's going to be a separate skeleton from a separate incident between
that.
Me and my car from this point.
You don't know that.
Doug's got things hidden down there, probably, like the people under the stairs.
That was in the movie in a category. I could put it in a category.
Poor
I think it's
Frumbert. Like,
movies that where people live under the stairs.
What movie?
Oh, okay. Well, bye, Kelly. Everybody at home, wave goodbye to Kelly.
Hey, you at home, you're not waving.
Keep waving.
You go.
All right. So, how embarrassed do you guys feel that you got pummeled?
I feel like a big fat piece of shit.
Whatever. It's my first time.
Not your first time playing the game.
They don't know that.
Yeah, that's right. Again, giving away our show business secrets.
You fuck show business.
You dink.
Watch.
I got him flustered.
This show is ground to a halt. God damn it.
Well, I didn't write Kelly wins niggers. I wrote Kelly's dick is huge.
You know, in the 1800s, Kelly wins niggers would mean something different.
Kelly would be pretty happy to win a couple of niggers.
Well, yeah, only because he'd get to make love to the women. He'd be a slave freer.
He'd pull a Jefferson.
Yeah, absolutely. Guy was an illegitimate half black baby.
Oh no, I met a George Jefferson and moved to a D-list.
all comes full circle.
All right. Let's get this ball continuing to roll here.
Time
so,
to suck today's
dick. Absolutely. Chewie told Kelly, but we're going to start again, so Chewie gets to pick this time.
Hey! Party,
because you picked the whole goddamn
me picking has gone just horribly so far. So
I've also kept track of our win-loss records. You are not doing too good, my
I'm
friend.
Not.
You are not. You've won one and lost three.
Is Kelly going to keep winning when you have to pick?
And my win was against Kelly.
Yeah,
it was amazing.
You swept Kelly.
Yeah.
I beat you 3-1, and he beat me 3-2.
Yeah.
That was a big-ass season. Okay, Justin Chu, would you like Major League Baseball movies?
No.
Oliphant Man?
No.
Movies of Timothy Oliphant? Okay, well then you're picking whatever the third one is?
Justified the movie.
Let's go with, we'll go, there's so many that I want to use, but I can't use them all.
It's a tough life.
I'm gonna go, well, I'm gonna use All Bombs again, which is a movie that Leonard gave a bomb to.
Sure. You flipped through no less than 26 pages.
Oh, I have a lot of money.
It was amazing.
I have no life. This is okay. Let's see. Let's go. Would you like one from 1996, 2001, or 2005?
2001.
These are bombs.
These are movies that he gave a bomb to.
Okay.
Like he mailed physically a bomb.
Yes, movies that Leonard Maltin committed a terrorist act against.
Okay.
Movies Leonard Maltin tried to fly a plane into.
The movies that Leonard Maltin tried to 9/11. 9/11 is now a verb.
Yeah.
9/11 LARPing.
I don't know if we need to do. Yeah, we gotta do Afghanilark first.
Oh, that's
somebody's
right.
Somebody's got a friendly fire. Scott.
Ah, yes.
What are you guys playing? 9/11.
Is it terrible that I think we've told you that we used
in
to play
9/11? In your late teens.
No, well, it was when it happened.
Yeah.
Well, so it happened in 2001, so I was 16.
Yeah.
Turning 16, or
you could have had a driver's license, and you were playing 9/11.
It's a fun game. Don't knock it till you try it. You get to have fake work conversations with your friend in Tower 2, and then your tower gets hit, then his tower gets hit. Oh, yeah, hey, man, how's it going? Oh, it's terrible. My boss is really riding my ass right now. Yeah, I know. It really sucks over here, too. What are you going to play for tonight? Oh, I'm just going to watch the Knicks game and, there's something coming towards the building. Oh, is it like a bird or something? I don't know. I can't really. Oh, my God, it's a plane! Oh, my God, somebody just hit the tower one. Everybody, quick, come look. Oh, my God, what's happening? Oh, there's something coming towards this tower, too. Oh, that's good. Oh, my God, it's another plane! And then you just jump off the jungle gym.
I will reframe
that as if you are on the jungle gym, it's a little too high. You can take a couple steps down and jump off.
Safety first.
Yeah, you don't want to hurt yourself playing 9/11. No,
you don't want workers' comp on your ass on that one.
No. Okay, so obviously Leonard gave this movie a bomb. So 2001.
Was this movie 9/11? Yes, that's the same year.
It is the same year, but it is not 9/11. It is a potentially clever idea, degenerates into a overlong, bloody, and in brackets, bloody awful bore.
Oh.
All the violence is mindless. All the plot developments are brainless. And that is it. There is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. 13 actors.
Start off with 13.
12.
11.
10.
9.
Name it.
9 names to Mr. Justin Chu.
All right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. Your names are Paul Anka, David K, Ice-T.
Don't watch the monsters.
Now sing an Ice-T song.
Cop killer, look at me, I'm a cop killer.
In the most monotone white man voice.
I don't know if he said look at me. That was an ad lib.
Okay, Paul Anka, David K, Ice-T, Bokeem Woodbine, Thomas Hayden Church, Howie Long, John Lovitz, David Arquette, and Kevin Pollak.
Holy shit. This is a mess of actors.
It really is.
Now some people.
All walks of life.
There's actors, there's some singers, there's a football player.
Yeah.
There's a former WCW heavyweight champion.
There's a cornucopia of just John Lovitz. Unrelated actors on there.
How many more actors were there on top of that?
Well, like four on top. Four that probably would have made it obvious.
Yes.
I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Kevin Pollak was the highest billing that I got.
I will say that the director has a fucking awesome name.
Harry Poot.
Whoa. I'm dying over here. Outside is horrible for me.
And the outer doors just don't.
I need to become Bubble Boy.
Get along. Which is another movie we should watch.
Well, we have to, but I don't want to find it.
Jake Gyllenhaal's finest work.
What's Jake? Today.
It was.
Wow. Two days.
Spiky hair.
You know who else is in it? Stacy Keibler.
Really?
She's got a minor horror role.
Huh. Pre-wrestling.
No, it's 2001.
Oh, is it?
I think it's 2001.
Oh, fuck me. I thought it was like 96.
No, it's like 2001.
Alright.
So she would have been just at the end of her WCW.
Rescind my previous statement.
Good.
Mid wrestling.
Oh, do we want to do our corrections
from
department
the corrections
later?
Department?
Later.
We'll do it right after Justin gets this wrong.
I got nothing. This
you're
is
fucked.
This is
Let's
terrible.
Get some more names.
Do you think you have an idea?
I would like some more names.
Okay. The top four billings are Christian, don't call me Heath Slater, Courtney Cox, Kurt Russell, Kevin Costner.
What? What are those fucking people doing in 2001?
Do you want me to read the review? Because it's very small.
Sure.
All right. A gang of Elvis impersonators.
Oh, 3,000 miles of Graceland.
It is a bomb.
Haven't seen it. Not gonna see it.
It's
Thank you for picking it. Just a lot of things on the table. That being said, I have a point.
It's a movie.
It's a movie.
It's a movie.
It is technically a movie.
It was a movie that was made.
What do we have from the corrections department?
Oh, yeah. From the corrections department of last time, I said that Delroy Lindo was born and raised in America, and he was, in fact, born and raised in London, England.
But...
Which is still not
I was gonna say, does that make it any better that he gets typecast as an African warlord?
No, he is definitely... does not make it any different. I just needed to correct myself.
Oh, yeah. Delroy.
There might have been another correction that I don't remember now, but there was another one from the second episode. Yeah. But it's no big deal. Alright, so Scott has 1 point.
Fuck you.
And,
yeah, no one's happy with that movie pick, by the way. No one's happy.
So Scott told Chewy to name it, so it is Justin
picking again.
Yay. Would you like... Okay, let's see what I got in the back catalog.
This seems to work better when I don't pick.
Yeah.
Let's keep this going.
Fantastic Mr. Fox, the movies that have lost star Matthew Fox.
Is he that fantastic?
Fox.
He's beating his wife.
He's good at breathing heavy.
Breathing Heavy and Beating His Wife. These are both
honed
skills of his.
Iron Lady, movies with a female robot.
Hmm.
Or,
you should put a comma in there. Iron Lady, movies with misogynism.
Or a category that I'm not super excited about. I stole it from the real game, but it needs to be used at some point, which is Black That Gas Up. It's a movie starring one of or both Jack Black or Kyle Gass.
Ugh. That sucks.
So, Jack Black, Kyle Gass. What did I say? Iron Lady, female robots, or Fantastic Mr. Fox?
Let's go Iron Lady.
Iron Lady. Would you like one from 1987?
Boo.
1997?
Boo.
Or 2005?
Boo. I just don't like this category.
Let's go 87.
Ugh. 87.
Feel like that pick is going to fuck both of us.
Yes. I'm taking you down with me.
You more than me.
Okay, Leonard gives it 2.5 stars. Mm. Yeah, I'm okay with that. Oh man, there is not a lot that I can say that does not give this movie away, so maybe I should choose another one.
It's gotta be something. Just some adjectives or something?
Well, it says it's basically a collection of jokes, both verbal and visual. Enough of them are funny to make for pleasant, if not hilarious, fare. But then the rest of it, it just tells what the movie is.
Okay.
So I guess that makes you know that it's a comedy.
Yeah.
There is, holy fuck.
It was my guess.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 names.
Start with 14, fuck.
13.
12.
Name it.
12?
You cock.
12 names. I think he might get it.
You cock.
There is a chance he might get it.
There's a larger chance he won't.
Well, I'm going to say...
I'm going to bet on Scott on this one.
Okay, so you got 12 names, so it's everybody but the top two.
All right.
Which I will say are in a weird order. Dom DeLuise.
Good start.
Joan Rivers.
Oh, Joan Rivers.
Rhonda Shear. Ronnie Graham.
Oh, Rhonda
John
Shear.
John Hurt.
Lorraine. John Hurt. I'm so good at the impression.
Lorraine Yarnell. Michael Winslow.
Spaceballs.
You nailed it. Spaceballs.
You.
So Joan Rivers was the Iron Lady.
Yeah, she was. She was the voice of the Iron Lady.
Yep.
All right. Not a sweet.
Michael Winslow's like, yep, got it.
Not a sweet. Not a sweet. Not a sweet.
Oh, yeah, not a sweet.
Who do you think you are?
I am.
Okay, so it was Scott Judy.
I guess it's still Kelly's gonna get a point.
Oh, no. Kelly's gonna somehow win this point.
Okay, Justin, it's back to you.
From the dead. Kelly's a skeleton now, by the way.
You told me to name it.
I'm gonna go back to the very beginning. We'll go with Month of the Year. So it's a movie that has a month in the title.
August Rush.
Was
that on the list?
It was on the list, nice. But now I can't use it. So stop guessing.
What a faggy pick. Who would you have picked?
Both of you.
November Rain the movie. It's a man's movie. August Rush, fucking kid with a flute or some shit.
The violin.
Whatever, it's gay.
Okay, gay. We'll go
not. And if I am, I'm not as gay as that fucking movie. I haven't seen it.
You don't know really gay. You can be like...
Patrick Wilburton and Ted.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'm gay.
are we done with the sidebar?
Yeah, we're done.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I know you're on the second category to go from yet.
Well, because you guys were talking. I know you're on the second category. Okay. Deuce Bigelow, European Filmalo, movie filmed in a European city.
That's a terrible title.
I feel like there's got to be a better way to phrase that one.
Nope, it works.
We need to
suck my wiener.
We need to workshop.
It's the end of the world as we know it, and I feel fine. They are natural disasters.
Yes.
Okay.
That.
I will say, do you want 2004, 2003,
1996? Is it Dante's Peak? It's always Dante's Peak, right?
We already used Dante's Peak last time, so we'll have to wait one more.
04, you say...
It's fine. The thing's probably not picking them up. We're far enough from the road. Okay. 3 stars. 2004.
That seems much better than...
Way more stars than the movie I was thinking.
Yeah.
Or most disaster movies. 3 stars is pretty good.
It's really good for a disaster movie.
The characters are likable. The dialogue isn't dumb. And the effects are spectacular. In other words, a pretty good old-fashioned disaster movie. And there are 10 names.
Seems way too high for anything. That was a disaster movie.
2004, yeah, 3 really stars.
Still 10.
9.
8.
7.
Name it.
All right.
All but the top 3, huh?
Will I get it? I'll get it, right?
We'll see. Feeling okay, good. You got Perry King... Austin Nichols, Jay O'Saunders, Kenneth Welsh, Dash Mahook, Cela Ward, and Emmy Rossum.
Those helped a whole lot of nothing.
Well, top three were the ones to go with.
Emmy Rossum. The hell is she in?
Disaster movie 2004. None of the things are good. I'll ask you a question. You can choose to answer or not. Do you agree with Leonard's star rating?
I choose not to answer your question. I will answer your question
with another question.
2.5 is reasonable. 3 is maybe on the slight on the high side, but I could see him giving it a 3. Like, it's not outlandish. So, like, it shouldn't be a bomb, but 3 is slightly high.
I'll go with my initial thought when you said the year, but I think the star rating is too high for it, and I think the dialogue in it was dumb, and Leonard specifically said it
wasn't dumb. Yeah.
But it's all I got, so let's go the day after tomorrow.
Top 3 names on the list were Ian Holm, Jake Gyllenhaal, Dennis Quaid.
Dennis Quaid, suck my dick.
Don't look at me when you say that. Look at him.
When I said suck, I was looking at you, and then I turned as I was saying it, and I finished with dick on Justin.
Tyler was not smart in that movie.
Well,
I know, right? Leonard, and people were not likable in that
Leonard
movie.
Leonard thinks it was, so.
There was no character development in that
Leonard
movie.
Leonard Wiener.
Well, yeah, that was generous, Leonard. I'm really proud of myself, though. I went purely on year.
Yeah.
I'm
definitely there for tomorrow, but, like,
I know.
I am not using that category again tonight. I'm not using that category again tonight on this one, so I am disappointed that Justin did not choose 2003, because it is his and my favorite disaster movie.
Yes, idiots.
The core.
You're an idiot for not liking it.
Yeah, I agree. You are the stupid one.
By the way, I'm really glad you didn't pick that year, because you would have one more point and I would have one less point right now.
So Justin told you to name it, so it is
me.
You picking the category.
Point to Summers.
What?
Point to Summers.
Point to Summers. Who brings back?
Skeleton?
Skeleton Kelly Summers is back in the building.
He legitimately is back.
He's really back? He's wearing less clothes? What's happening?
He came back to steal our points.
Did you come back to steal our points? You son of a bitch. You monster.
I gotta say, I wasn't proud about how I left things. Alright. So, we'll give you guys another shot.
What?
At the champ?
Whoa.
At the champ.
Shot at the champ.
Okay, well.
Got my apple.
Go sit down in your seat that's right there. Are we letting him back in the game at 2-1?
Are you
actually playing for a game?
Okay.
Okay.
And then you're back?
Yeah.
All right.
You have to work tomorrow?
No, I do, but...
Oh, you're just...
Just wasn't happy with the way things
now. The things ended? Okay. Scott, you get a category you did quite well at last time.
Huh?
Twoop relief, where somebody takes a dump while having a conversation with someone.
See. What was the category called?
Twoop relief.
Nice.
Twoop, of course, Chewy, is the...
Is the...
Act of...
Act of...
Tweeting on the shitter.
Yes. Tweeting while pooping.
Thank you to Roberto Luongo for bringing that to the world.
I will give you Fat Tattooey, movies starring a fat comedian that you did horrible in because you don't know Pixar was shit.
Yeah. You haven't listened to the last episode, Justin. But
or any episode.
That's what I've been doing, so.
Turns out I have never seen a Pixar movie.
Hmm.
Yeah.
He should kill himself.
Yeah, those
yes.
Boys.
Yeah, go ahead.
As
it hits the clothesline and drops directly.
I was hoping it would hit the clothesline.
Okay, so Fatatouille, fat comedian, and let's go hot ticket item, which is a term I stole from work. ticket item.
Here's a question. I have a question. As I was coming in, I heard my name mentioned. Did I actually come back in when I was being referenced again?
Yeah. Yes. You got the time. It was the call, the curtain call.
Oh.
Go down. And then you go, yeah,
we are. Were you yelling at me in gorilla position?
Yes.
God damn it! Get out of here! Get out there! Break that fucking table! Snap that dick! Get them eggs! Get those eggs! Yeah, get those eggs!
Okay, hot ticket item means... that it is one of the top 25 highest grossing in theaters in the United States.
Of all time?
Of all time.
Interesting. Oh. That narrows it down to 25 movies.
But it won't necessarily be number one or two. It'll be a random one. I'm not giving you a number.
It's still going to be a largely popular movie, though.
Yes.
But that all being said, as a fat comedian myself, I feel like I must redeem myself. So let's go Fat Tattooey.
Okay. What'd you like?
Not a comedian.
I've been hilarious this episode.
2010.
You guys think I'm a fat monster.
Okay,
oh,
would you like
a monster?
2010.
Yeah.
2010 or 1995.
I don't have three 2010.
No, I had a line lined up for that.
1995.
Which line do you know?
Oh, there's two?
No, there's nope. 2001. 2010, so I was just
talking. Give me the fucking 1995.
Okay. Okay, calm down, big man.
I am calm!
Oops, I spelled that wrong. Too many things. Stop giggling over there.
Sorry, I read something funny.
Okay, well, what were you reading? Tell us.
Share with the class. Loco posted this.
Matthew Gross.
Shout out.
Loco.
Shout out.
Is it just me, or does Christina Ricci look like she gets younger as she gets older?
Which is very true.
Very true. Very true.
Okay. Mr. Moulton gives us 2.5 stars. 1995. Okay. A top cast is wasted in this one joke premise which lacks the satiric edge it needs. The director stumbles with his second film after the terrific whatever his first film was. And it's got 11 names.
Give me 11.
11?
10. 9.
8.
7.
6.
Name it.
Who's ignoring Kelly's muscles right now?
Everyone but Kelly.
Six names, you said?
6.
Justin Chu, you're 6 names.
You're not getting 6 of 11. Did everything fall out of your pants at once?
It's a tough one. There are some names in here.
This is a 1996 fat comedian?
Yes. 5. 1995 fat comedian.
Okay. That changes nothing.
Brad Sullivan.
Brad.
James Belushi.
James Belushi.
Not to be confused with later named... What the fuck's his name now?
Jim.
Jim Belushi. Ow. I wanted to call him Joe Belushi. Stephen Wright. Funny man.
Funny man.
G.D. Spradling, Bill Nunn, and Kevin J. O'Connor. Nah, I don't know that any of those names... Cool.
Good luck, fucker.
I will say James Belushi is not the fat comedian because he wasn't really fat in the 90s. No. He's fat now.
Yes. And not a comedian ever.
He tries.
He tries.
According to Jim, doesn't have its moments, but they try.
I like... They mean well?
They mean well. They got good spirits.
I like that movie where he's with the dog. That's funny.
Yes.
If I knew Jim Belushi's canon better, I was trying to think of a movie with him and an ugly woman, so yeah. I could reference that, but I don't know his movies.
Nobody does. Thankfully. Even James Belushi doesn't know his movies. This is actually for the win. We didn't mention that. It's got shit.
I should probably stop tapping my foot on the table where the microphone is.
Yeah.
Apologies for the last however long I did that for.
I have no clue what this movie is, so I'm going to name the movie that I assumed was going to be the winner of the category no matter what year was picked. That movie being Rat Race.
Ooh.
That is not the right year.
No, I know it's not the right year.
Even close. All right, the rest of the, the rest of the cast off, right? Goes...
98.
Rip Torn.
Later than that?
Yeah. Wow. Rip Torn.
Kevin Pollak again.
We're not hosting it.
Rhea Perlman.
Rhea Perlman.
John Candy.
Fat.
Alan Alda.
Skinny.
Uncredited cameo Dan Aykroyd, not number one, but I didn't read that in the review because I wasn't sure if it would give it away or not.
I don't think it would have.
Nope.
The director is Michael Moore, the same Michael Moore who does stupid political bullshit.
Oh, I didn't know he made movies.
Yeah, he did. He made quite a few, actually, in the 90s.
Canadian Bacon.
Mm, fuck off.
The last John Candy movie before he was dead with...
No, the last one was by Wagon East.
2 pounds of... Well, fuck you. 2 pounds of...
You and I both did that.
No? Wagon's East, 1994. Canadian Bacon, 1995.
What? Fuck.
Proof?
My ass.
You aren't arguing this point, but I'm going to show it at you anyways.
What were you going to say?
Almost 100% certain Wagon's
East. Oh, when he was dead, and they found him dead, and they gave the autopsy, he had 2 pounds of M&Ms in his belly.
That's a good way to go out.
That's a good way to go out. So, Scott, you brought your total up from...
Goddamn right,
from one win to two, but you have 3 losses.
Look,
It's against multiple people. You can't win them all.
Come That's on, true. But... So are you going to do this, or do you want me to go another round with you three?
I feel like we've exhausted.
No, you haven't exhausted my categories. I've got a million.
Oh, no. Not your categories. Just
I have
this game.
Just
I have a category
you,
that's like
you
almost
talking
40
this
long.
Good. Is it your 40 favorite movies?
Actually,
it's my favorite movies.
Well, I can think of some.
I should probably start thinking some categories, huh?
You should. If you want to be a big shot host like us.
I can't host.
All right, so that means
I can't
Scott
dance.
Wins.
I can't so... What else can I not do?
You and Sammy.
Derp.
Around.
We kitty cat drew along.
Look.
What? Nuzzle them?
Yeah.
Okay, well,
I'm sure you do, but you know what doesn't make for good audio? Nuzzling a kitty cat.
it makes for good nuzzling.
Sure. Once we switch the video, you can have all the kitties you want. It can be your gimmick. But until then, lay off the kitties until the show's over.
Are we going to show and, like, hand draw us sitting around in a booth?
What, like that?
Can I sing about nuzzling kitties while I nuzzle the kitties?
That makes sense.
That's good audio.
We have to have a kitty, so go find him. He's out and about in the world. I would like to say that the first one, since I put Kelly's dick is huge, for Scott, I put Scott wins. They're great.
Boom.
Hey, like a wiener.
Are we going straight to this, or are we building a title?
We can do build a title if you want.
All right.
Or we could try the game that I hate.
Which one?
A, B, C, D's nuts.
No.
Should we do it once?
I beat that fucking game.
Screw it. That sounds terrible.
Just, do you even know what it is?
No, but it sounds stupid.
You just go down the alphabet, and you have to name a movie that starts with A, the next person is B, the next person is E, until you can't, like, somebody's, until everybody's out, it's down to one.
But to make it a little tougher.
It does go a little faster.
Yeah, to make it a little tougher, movies with the, they're all under T.
Yeah.
So T is super easy, and everything else is harder.
Yeah.
And what Doug has done lately, after you get through the alphabet once, because before you just keep cycling through the alphabet, and if everyone there knows a lot of movies, it goes forever and gets tedious.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what he did last time I listened was A through Z and then numbers, which is interesting. Which,
that is interesting.
Which you can do up to, I think, 22.
Wow.
Yeah. There's something for each number until
I can think of 21.
Is it 21?
It's 21.
Very good.
Or 21 Jump Street.
Or 21 grams. Wow, three.
Or 21 grams. Yeah, 21. That's weird.
Well,
21 Angry Men.
The dyslexic jury.
Okay, build title. Let's do this.
Okay.
I hope that was really loud for people.
That was pretty loud.
I also scared Chewy awake. He's having cardiac arrest
now.
Let's go. I'm just looking at current movies.
Okay, make it better than last time, because you only got one last time.
You
got the lucky one.
Because Paul's has nothing.
No,
nothing.
I mean, when you chose the lucky ones last time, telling I could think of one movie.
Oh, you guys were dumb. There were tons you could do.
You're dumb. You're a Jew. Hey.
How?
Well, gotta insult somebody.
Well, jeez, come on.
Last time it was people's accents. This time it's the Jews.
Let's go with something with a lot of things. All right, let's try that, see if we get anywhere with it. The Big Year. So we cut out the. So you're working off Big Year, basically.
I guess I can't say big.
You cannot say big.
Who are we starting?
You.
So it has to end in big, or start with year?
Yes.
Big or, year one.
There you go.
That's what I was thinking. So I guess it's me.
Sure.
Big year 101 Dalmatians.
And this could be over quick. Looking to end in big, or start with... Dalmatians, or part of that word.
You're giggling.
This is stupid.
That's That's tough. I feel like I might have started with a bad movie for this, but...
Hey, at least we got two.
We got two. It's maybe the fewest number of letters we've dealt with so far.
Mm-hmm. Dalmatians. What the fuck can you do with Dalmatians?
You know what? Not a lot. Is there something you can do with big?
Not ending in big. Is that for the movie Big?
Does he turn back into a little kid at the end of that movie?
Yes.
I think so.
Doesn't he fuck that broad?
Not as a kid.
No, but I mean...
That'd be gross.
No, I mean... When
I think he does. When he's big. I'm pretty sure he does. Yeah.
And then, well, what happens when he becomes a kid? What's he going
to
do?
Then she goes to jail.
No. It's got to be...
Then he has jerk-off fodder forever.
he's got a lot of spank bank going on.
Turns out there are no current movies that are good for Build a Title.
I thought of one and then lost it, and now I'm trying to think of what it is again.
For this one?
Just take it, Summers. This is painful.
I think it goes to me, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It goes to Drew.
I thought of one that wasn't the right title, but some like it big. Some like it.
That was the porno that Marilyn Monroe made.
Some like it big.
Yeah, I don't think that's a movie.
I want to say that there is a movie called Mr. Big.
I want to say that too.
But if you ask me who's in it, I'm going to say people. Actors.
They call me Big. Mr. Big.
Mr. Big is a candy bar and is also the name of that asshole from Sex and the City, I think.
Yes.
Unfortunately, that is correct.
I don't know who that is, but...
Wasn't Mr. Big like a musical act too, like the late 80s?
Yes. And it was not a movie.
Summer's wins by...
Is there a movie? I'm pretty sure I've seen it called How to Make It Big. I think it's like one of those ensemble cast comedies.
That sounds like a documentary.
That could be a thing.
How to Make an American Quilt. How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying.
How to
Make a Monster. How to Be Very, Very Popular, 1955.
How to Get Ahead in Advertising. Good movie.
Great movie.
How to Get Hard.
Know How to Make It Big.
I guess I'm out.
Well,
also, I'm just going to continue his dominance then.
That could have gone better.
At least I'm opposing him.
Let that be the last thing Kelly wins. Yes.
I feel like...
not only in this, but in life.
I feel I'll have more success with Drew's movies than I will with anyone else's.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
So, I think
you guys slept together for some
time. Why did you close it again?
Because I set it down. I set down the iPad, so I closed the application. Pick it back up, I will reopen it.
You might be a legal retard.
As opposed to an illegal retard.
Yeah, of course. A Mexican retard.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's talk...
Don't shake your head in disapproval. You hate Mexicans just as much as I do.
Who said that?
You said that last time we hung out.
Yeah.
When we weren't recording.
Yeah, okay.
Before we turned on the recording, I fucking hate those goddamn Mexicans.
O-Q-U-A-Y. Okay, guys. Let's just calm down.
Okay.
Well, let's talk current things. Let's talk number one movie at the box office 5, 10, 15, or 20 years ago today.
I would like
July 6, 2012.
You updated?
Oh, yeah.
Fuck.
Oh, yeah. Someone didn't do much at work today. Also, current, it is Sylvester Stallone's birthday today.
Why?
Which is why we're doing the movies of Jeffrey Rush. Whose birthday it also is, and is a much better actor than Sylvester Stallone.
I would say I enjoy Stallone's movies better, but Jeffrey Rush is an Academy Award winner, but Sylvester Stallone did make The Expandables.
Yes.
Expandables.
That's the fat version. And third...
So that one movie, Copland.
Yeah, Copland, where he's punch drunk and fat.
Yes.
Third category, four-letter movies.
Can you give me an example of a four-letter movie?
Fuck. Chud.
I was hoping you were going to go Chud. Three in a row.
Isn't it Chudza?
No, it's no. Chud. That's Cannibalistic Humanoid Underground Dwellers.
Chud was the sequel, wasn't it?
No.
No, Chud 2.
The sequel was Chud 2, Bud Chud.
No, Bud the Chud.
Sorry, Bud the Chud.
Bud the Chud. Their first mistake was taking the corpse. The second mistake was waking it up.
That's right.
Anyways,
okay, which of those options?
What do you like? What's your pleasure? Number one box office, Jeffrey Rush, 4 letters.
Your heart?
No, he said disappointingly. For the first time today, I am not hard.
You gotta take a break.
You guys are gonna be so flaccid.
I hope that was audible.
Let's go with number one box office.
Number one box office. 5, 10, 15, or 20 years ago.
I would like you to go 50 years on that, just so we can see.
Number one in the box office, 50 years ago.
That's right, that's 1962.
52, 62, if you want to actually take away 50 years. Yes, yes, that's fine.
62.
What year is it? Where am I?
Who's the president?
15 years?
15.
Wow. It's
taking us to 1997.
What was popular in 97? Spice Girls. Could be Spice World.
Oh, Spice World's a good movie. Oh. Idiots.
Stop naming movies out loud.
Born to be Wild.
What?
That was the way she takes the gorilla. Yeah, cross country in the back of the ice cream truck, yeah.
What? I haven't fucking heard of this thing, and I'm glad I haven't.
It was a kids movie.
There was a
kids.
Lot of gorilla movies out at that time.
There's a lot of gorilla movies, period. Jonathan Taylor Thomas, isn't it? No, it's the kid that looks like Jonathan Taylor Thomas.
Wait. This is baffling. I got a lot of problems with all of this.
He has a gorilla, he puts him in the back of an ice cream truck, and he drives him across country to release him in the middle of the
woods.
American?
Oregon.
Yeah, his native Oregon.
I don't know. Is that where he's going, Oregon?
I don't know.
California?
I think this would be a flawed premise.
I think he's take because I think they want to put him to the zoo and he wants to take him to like an ape reserve.
Nice zoo?
Yeah, yeah.
A nicer zoo?
There's no nice zoos.
There's baby zoo.
We have one. No baby zoo. There is one zoo in Vancouver, and two animals die there a year.
Yeah, it's not really in Vancouver.
That's true.
Yeah.
But it's considered. It's Vancouver Zoo.
Yeah, it's.
But it's in Langley, is it not?
Yeah.
Or
Abbotsford.
Abbotsford?
Aldergrove?
Aldergrove, yeah.
Some place that only hicks live.
Yeah. Some place where we can say whatever we want about them because they don't know how to get podcasts.
They don't have internet access.
All right, what the hell are we talking? Okay, so we're talking about the number one movie, not number two or three, Kelly. The number one movie in America.
Whatever.
Number one.
Okay.
In America, July 4th weekend, America. Big weekend.
America.
15 years ago today, 1997.
America.
All right, continue. 3 stars.
Yep.
Pretty good for a summer movie type thing. Only 7 actors. Let me tell you about it. Outrageous and original at every turn. Can't say that. Sharp pacing that never lets up. Snappy script. Based on the Malibu comic by Lowell Cunningham. Followed by a sequel and an animated TV series.
Whoa!
What? These ones wouldn't help me.
No, that wasn't what I thought it was going to be.
That's not what I thought it was either.
I have no clue.
What it could be. 3 stars, 7 actors. What do you got?
I was thinking Chud 3. Seven. The Return of Bud the Chud.
I will confirm that it is not Chud 3.
Anyways.
I said 7.
Who's it going to?
Kelly says 7. Let's start clockwise. 2, Justin. 6.
I guess, by default, I will go 5.
The same name as...
Niggers.
So all but the top two. Top two would help a lot, but you've got a shot. Decent shot, actually.
Okay, hook it up.
Siobhan Fallon.
Jimmy Fallon's black brother?
Siobhan.
Probably sister.
Or black sister?
Yeah.
Does she also read off teleprompters?
Yes.
Okay.
Tony Shalhoub.
Not a fan.
Monk.
Not a fan.
Oh, God damn it.
Kelly knows.
Yeah.
I feel like this is... I'm going to figure it out pretty soon. Vincent D'Onofrio.
I know who Vincent D'Onofrio is.
Rip Torn.
Oh, okay. I know what it is. Keep
Linda
going.
Fiorentino.
God damn.
Hit me up.
Men in Black.
You got it.
Yeah.
I was... At first, I thought it was Independence Day.
I thought Independence Day, too, but Independence Day is 98?
No, earlier. Five or six.
96. Is it really?
Definitely yep. pre-97.
That's 96.
Yeah, 96, I think. Right.
Yay, I don't care. I got that point.
No, shut up. This is already better than last game. Probably because I'm not involved in it. Okay. Maybe Kelly and I can't be in the same game.
Possibly. Or maybe you just need to learn movies that I would choose for categories.
I don't know how your dumb head works.
So it's Justin to...
Yes, Justin going to Drew.
Okay.
No, Justin to Kelly.
Justin going to Kelly, like
yeah.
I said.
Yeah. Sorry, I don't want to correct you.
Clean out your ear holes.
I'll clear out my blood hole.
From Justin to Kelly.
From Justin to Kelly, a fine movie. Bomb. Let's go with... Number one, Best Picture Losers. Mm. Number two, Bet You Can't Name the Whole Movie Title. I need the full movie title for that one. And it is also Ned Beatty's birthday, so the films of Ned Beatty.
No, Bet You Can't Name the Whole Title.
No, fuck off.
Ooh, first time. Long time listener, first time caller, except he's never listened.
I think he's going to eat us.
You have. There is a moth the size of a pterodactyl going on out here.
Two of them, they're going to mate, they're going to match.
And make an even bigger one. Yeah. They combine all their crazy recessive genes and make some sort of super moth.
Super retard moth.
Your options for Bet You Can't Mothra. Name the Whole Title. 2003, 2010, 2011.
Let's go current, 2011.
2011. Good fucking luck.
You shit.
You brought this.
You know what? There was one that I thought you were going to pick for this category.
Uh-huh.
Wasn't one of the ones you gave the option for, but I'm fairly certain it's also in one of mine, so okay. I hope I get the choice.
I hope so, too. For you.
Rubby hands.
Skin flakes.
All right, so...
Skin flakes?
Skin flakes.
Oh, flakes.
Skin flicks?
Yeah.
That's like the porno version of Netflix?
Yeah.
Hey, copyright.
Well, if it's in Canada, you're only getting one film.
Yeah.
Grand Theft Anal.
Grand Theft Anal.
Let's hope something different happens.
Remember when we got Horror of the Rings?
Yeah.
And the guy's fighting the giant papier-mâché dragon?
Is it a giant papier-mâché dick?
And then it, like, sprays all over her. And they have porno actor Napoleon in it, and he doesn't get to bang anybody!
The hell's
he's the midget who was playing Dildo Baggins.
That's pretty good.
I hate this. All right. Your movie, where you must name the whole title, or God help your soul.
2011.
2011. Too recent for a star rating, because it takes Leonard at least one full year to give anything a star rating.
Hmm.
So should you really use it? That's kind of cheating.
That's too bad for you.
You're fucking us over here.
13 actors, here is some stuff about it. He, from his review, it looks like about 2 stars.
Hmm.
But take that for what you will. That's my interpretation.
Have you seen it?
None of your fucking business.
Well, yeah, it is my fucking business.
No, I haven't seen it.
Okay. So what star rating would you give it?
having not seen it, 1.5 to 2.
Okay.
And Leonard looks to be about a 2. That being said, it's not a guarantee that this is a Pixar movie. There are, in fact, other movies I also haven't seen.
Yes. Anything that's not the last movie in a sequence of movies.
Exactly.
No fourths.
He's only seen thirds, fourths, fifths.
I would love that. I might go see Saw 8.
There's not making Saw 8. Fuck you.
They make 7?
Yeah.
I might go see 7 sometime.
We can watch tonight.
I'd prefer not.
Okay.
Okay, let's talk about this fucking movie. No, that's plot. I was primed for adventure laced with humor and got just that for a while. It would have been nice to learn a bit about the main character, who is something of a cipher, as opposed to the instantly endearing secondary character. I was utterly unprepared for the second half of the film, which turns into one gigantic action sequence, a propulsive, non-stop, video game-like experience without let-up. As a feat of movie making, it's impressive, but merciless. It overtakes the film and overwhelms the characters, not to mention us in the audience, trapped behind our 3D glasses. That's gotta be enough. So, gotta name the full movie title, 2011, recent movie,
13 actors.
Let's start with 13.
Business 13 going to Kelly.
11.
Skip one. Are we going odd numbers?
Fucking name it, you son of a bitch.
11. 11 of 13. I ain't got a lot of people. And in the top two, I don't even know how much they have. Tony Curran. Sonia Fortag. Tim Stengel.
Yeah.
Joe Starr. Gad El Male. Daniel Mays. Mackenzie Crook of British The Office and Pirates of the Caribbean fame. Toby Jones. Simon Pegg. Nick Frost, Simon Pegg's friend, and Daniel Craig. Only the top two are unlisted in that.
Oh. Okay, well, I know what it is, but I...
But I bet you can't name the full title. I could just see the cogs turning in your head right now. It's delightful. Brings me great joy. Especially the fact that you might result in someone else getting a point.
He'll probably get it. Because...
How you doing, Drew?
I hope he doesn't get it, because I might have just given him a fucking point.
I think he'll get it, because it's the last part of the title. Mm-hmm.
You want to give me the first part and think about the second?
Yeah, first part's The Adventures of Tintin.
Might well be. But what about that second part?
Voyage of the Unicorn?
Oh, man. That is impressive to the point that he...
Impressive?
Only, impressive. The fact that he only missed it by one word. The Adventures of Tintin, The Secret of the Unicorn. Point to Drew. Ill-earned, but a point nonetheless.
Whatever, I knew it. I don't know. You know what? I might have forgotten the secret, too. Yeah.
It's tough.
I would not have gotten that at all.
And Justin had no clue.
Yeah, so it's Justin...
All's well that ends well. Not a movie.
I didn't get Daniel Craig. I probably would.
I told Kelly, so now it's Justin to Kelly again?
Justin to you. Yes.
Yes, that's correct. In reverse order. Fuck you, guy.
Oh,
big man.
Have you been keeping track of the points? Because I haven't.
Two
nil nil.
Nil nil.
Oh, wow.
I could sweep the fucking board.
As long as someone who's not...
The board.
And I have closed the app again because we paused.
You're the worst.
All right. Let's talk about...
I hope that records. That was me getting a text message.
It probably will, I guess.
It's Inception. We added Inception sounds to the podcast.
Very good. Let's talk Razzie winners for Worst Picture. Let's talk either...
Big Charles over there.
Either Twakulu or America. Movies with red, white, or blue in the title.
America. Look at all these texty-text phone fags over here.
Or I prefer not to look at
them. Both on their phones, reading the tweets.
Or Beatlemania. Movies with John Paul, George, or Ringo in the title.
Sam Lane jokes last time?
Nope.
Aww.
See, we...
Rango.
I'm making a joke, you just said the word.
I actually thought that you were going to say, spoiler alert, most of them are Ringo.
What's the second category again? Second category was red, white, and blue.
Let's go with that.
America!
A red or white or blue movie from 1984, 1992, or 2004? Scratch that. Just 84 and 92. We've done 04 before.
Mm. That did sound familiar.
It was Harold and Kumar Go to White Castle.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we've done it. 84, 92. 92. 92. Three stars. Good movie. I... would sort of agree, maybe 2.5. 7 actors. Let's talk about what Leonard said about it. There we go. Okay. Smart, funny, highly profane comedy. Both stars look good. Film does become slightly redundant after a point. One of the two leads... girlfriends... her goal is to appear on Jeopardy. Some versions of the movie run 117 minutes. Others run 500 minutes. That part is not true. 3 stars, 7 actors. 92 has red, white, or blue in the title.
I'll go all on this one, 0.
Whoo! Oh boy! To Drew.
You know what, I had a movie in my head, but as soon as you said it, wasn't right, and I can't think of one other than the movie I was already thinking of, so I guess I'm going to concede and hope that Justin gets it wrong, so...
Which, in turn, will give you a sweep.
Yes.
If he is wrong.
Name the movie.
Is it Blue Chip?
It is a basketball movie. That is not Blue Chip.
What was it?
White Man...
Can't jump.
I believe Blue Chips was 1994.
And yes!
And had an S on the end. Unless there's a different movie called Blue Chip.
Is it Blue Chips?
The one in the shack?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, I sweep.
Yeah. I think my sweep was more impressive.
More aggravating.
I feel like White Man came later, but I guess...
Well, clearly it didn't. But...
I can confirm it didn't.
That's what it feels like with Independence Day. I was so sure it was 97.
My movie in my head was Hunt for Red October.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's not 92, is it?
No, that would have been
94.
Let's find out. Let's stop guessing.
So many bugs. They're attracting to your 90. Smell.
Okay.
Wow. Yep. Why can't you have left Blue Streak in there?
Yeah, I got Blue Streak.
Because you got us right.
But Kelly got it out like with minus 2.
Oh, yeah. No. Well, that was speedy and uneventful.
But at least someone who's not Kelly won. That's the important thing.
So somehow one had a gun to 1-3?
Yes. See, that's how easy it is to go 1-3. It's goddamn amazing I'm 2-3. 2-3 is looking pretty good all of a sudden.
I played one game today and I swept. Granted, I only had to guess one
correct. Scotty, thank you for bringing that. We're bumping the curve.
Exactly. That's what we're bringing in for. Well,
I guess are we shutting down for the evening?
Any chat or?
Yeah, we can.
Oh, we're all games.
Chat about what?
I'll chat about.
The thing is, we all saw the same movie, and it was the same movie that Kelly already talked about last time.
Oh, we've seen other movies in life.
Well, yeah. Are we going to talk about all movies in general?
All movies in life.
Well, why don't we talk?
We're talking about the movie Life. Which is awesome.
Oh, love that
I haven't
movie.
Seen it forever, so...
It's got a lot of black people in it.
It does.
It's also got mocha baby making.
Yep.
I approve of that. I'm down with
the swirl. Yeah, Kelly has been well spoken on the fact that he is down with the swirl.
What's wrong with being down with the swirl?
Nothing. I'm just saying you're down with it. You're also down with the brown.
Yeah.
I'm down with the brown.
Too much.
They have to be whitewashed, though. I can't handle... angry brown parents.
Or accents. Terrible.
It depends how bad they are. If they're really...
What about the smells?
Okay, now we're starting
like
to get...
Food or body odor?
They're the same thing.
That's fair.
It's the same smell. It's just where it's coming from.
Yeah, I'm not.
Either the dinner table or their fucking pussy.
Oh, man. How about that comment in the movie tonight? My breath smells like your wife's pussy. Nobody's ever had the balls to talk to me like that. Yeah. That's because their mouth is usually full of your wife's box.
You're hired. Shit. Guts. You're hired.
For those of you wondering, that was from the movie Ted, yeah. Which 3 of us saw today and one of us saw previously.
Before our last show.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah, not a ton to say that wasn't said last time. I think it delivered what you expected. There are definitely some really good laughs in it. I think I would have preferred if they just cut out the entire plot.
Yeah.
And just made the big jokes.
Yeah.
So I guess I should go watch Family Guy.
Pretty much.
Yeah, basically.
My problem with it is that I guess because all the people who are writers now are all like fanboys from the 80s and 90s. And so that.
These are more 80s than 90s.
I guess more 80s. But like every goddamn comedy is just you make a reference from pop culture from your childhood, bring it to now, and try and reintroduce it and force it on people to try and make it popular and get a laugh out of it. But, like, the reference in this one is so old that I'm too young to understand it. I don't know about you two. You're a little bit older than me. Did you guys ever...
Still too old for us.
Yeah. No? But you've seen it.
I've seen it.
I've never seen it.
It's not my thing, but I've seen it.
I don't know if you want to spoil what it is. I guess it doesn't really matter. It's not important to the plot.
It's not integral to the plot.
Yeah, it's fucking Flash Gordon is the thing that he brings back the movie. And, like, I had heard of it, never seen it.
Yeah, I know of it, but, like...
That should be on our next movie of bad movies to watch.
I feel like I've seen Flash Gordon.
I've seen Flash Gordon more than
I've seen Flash Gordon more times than yeah.
Appears to be a penis sword.
That's the only line I remember.
But yeah, so what other movie do we want to talk about? Fortress? I really want to see Fortress,
there,
by the way.
It's
friend of the show, Christopher Lambert. It's in the future, and they have restrictions on population control, and him and his wife are caught smuggling a baby across the borders, and they capture him and put him in the ultimate fortress prison, and he's going to try and get out to save his wife and baby.
When's this from?
1995, I want to say.
So this was shortly before he filmed that movie on
the and shortly before
which came up, which came up last time.
The Hunted.
Hunted, filmed before Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
But looks like it was filmed in 1970.
Yeah. You look like you were saying something.
There has to be some sort of movie we've seen that was like made us angrier than the Zohan, but I don't
know. You know what? What the hell? Leonard gave it a star and a half, and it's actually from 1993.
Fortress.
Seems awfully
high. Oh man, also starring Kurtwood Smith.
Nice.
Oh, wow. Kurtwood.
Kurtwood.
Red.
Good times.
So that must have been just after he was in RoboCop.
Yes.
Yeah. RoboCop was 1989.
RoboCop was.
I think it was the end of the 80s.
1987.
87, even earlier.
RoboCop 2, 89 or 90?
90, and RoboCop 3 was 93, but.
RoboCop 3
was a different guy, and it was just during that peak when they had gotten new technology for CGI and stuff. So they had like tried everything new that they had, right. And it was just brutal.
They're just throwing shit against the wall.
Brutal.
You are forgetting the most important moment in RoboCop history when he helped bust Sting out of the cage.
Yes, that is the most important thing he ever did.
Has there ever been a movie wrestling cross promotion that hasn't been awesome? I put it to you that there has not.
Well, yeah. Rick Steiner and Chucky promoting Bride of Chucky?
Yeah. Yes.
I don't even remember that.
That was great.
I was going to say Seed of Chucky, but then I'm like, they wouldn't say Seed on TV. That's disgusting.
It was WCW 2000, and they don't give a shit.
But yeah, it was Bride of Chucky.
As you name movies, I want to look them up and see what Leonard gave them. 2 stars for Seed of Chucky?
Bride of Chucky.
Really? He gave 2 stars?
2 stars to Seed of Chucky.
He gave 2 stars to, like, the Royal Tenenbaums. Like,
that's better than all the good Adam Sandler movies.
Also 2 stars.
I don't get Len
it's
sometimes.
It's like the Shaw on Demand that I have.
Oh, those ratings are terrible.
Crazy.
It gives him, like, 3 ratings for, like, almost everything. Like, 3 out of 5 for almost everything.
Except for good movies, which gives, like, 1.
I've noticed it gives, like, every movie pre-1970, like, 4 stars.
Yeah. Yes.
Like, if it's in black and white, it's great.
Is that because they consider it a better style of acting?
I don't know.
Or, like, a better quality of actors because there weren't as many actors?
I don't know. I don't know what the TV on demand rating system goes by. I think they're just throwing stuff out there.
Or they're too lazy to actually watch it, so they just
Yeah, I'm sure
people are watching this. 4 stars.
Yeah. Give it... Give Grandma something nice to watch while she dies.
Yeah, bring her memories back.
Be like, oh, everybody likes this movie. It's 4 stars.
Rock Hudson wasn't gay.
I remember back in the day when Rebels didn't have a car.
I wish James Dean had got old. That would have been weird.
That would have been weird.
I'm basically what would have happened if James Dean discovered carbohydrates in orthopedic shoes.
Does that mean we would have to deal with insufferable James Franco?
I feel like we wouldn't have got James Franco if James Dean had gone on longer.
The world would be a worse place without James Dean.
James Franco would just be some art school student that nobody really likes.
Bag instead of a guy that a lot of housewives beat themselves to. On,
Facebook?
Facebook themselves to?
No.
Yeah. No.
Feed their border collie stamp?
Wow. Wow. The other FB. Feed,
of course, border collie being one word and not two.
Yeah, you just say it quick. It works out.
Border collie. I don't know. I didn't run this by you, but we were saying...
Why didn't this come up in the production meeting?
Well, I did talk to you about it, but we never say yay or nay. But I was saying, like, instead of...
You know, we have a 3-hour production meeting before every show for a reason, Drew, so we can fucking vet this stuff.
My Monster Energy drink's kicking in right now, so I'm a little hyper. That I drank, 3 hours ago?
This is unprecedented, but fine.
Well, no, my idea was, instead of talking about what we currently saw, if we don't have anything to talk about, because we already talked about Ted, was we talk about, I don't know, a specific favorite of a genre or a type of movie, like our favorite dark comedies or our favorite
romance. By dark comedy, are we talking Wayans Brothers?
No, because I would say Blomity if it was that.
Oh, okay.
So we talk about The Core.
What about you? What about The Core? I love The Core.
What about picking a random year and saying your favorite movie?
That's too hard. I can't think of years.
Yeah.
What am I, retarded?
I mean, I might understand you guys don't know the precise year of every single movie you've ever seen?
I know some, not all.
Hmm.
But, or like, you know, of a specific actor or director or genre. Or we could talk about a movie that we absolutely hated.
Just as good.
Well, then, let's start off with a movie that we absolutely hated.
What are we going to rage on?
I don't know. What's a movie you absolutely hated?
There's a lot.
Okay, I've got a bunch in the bank, but go ahead.
Pick one.
Bucky Larson.
I didn't see it.
I bet you can't name the full title.
Probably not.
Born to be a star.
Born to be a star.
Let's show this film the proper respect.
My now, God, what a corn-studded piece of shit.
This movie came out in the fall of 2011.
Yeah, sure.
Which is around the time I started listening to the podcast, How Did This Get Made?
Okay.
Which every bi-monthly, they take a terrible, hopefully hilariously terrible movie, and just have a good time talking about it. And it was around that time I started getting into bad movies for the sake of bad movies. And then this Nick Swardson vehicle came out. I like Nick Swardson's comedy, all right. I've seen some of his stand-up.
He's kind of funny.
He's good. He's one of those guys, like, he's not gay? One of those guys?
Yeah, definitely.
I call it Michael Ian Black syndrome. And, so me, Justin, and Kelly went out and saw it for the sake of, which I don't, I will start doing more now because it was very enjoyable the first time, but actually going, I'll see something on video because I know it's a bad movie, but rarely do I go to the theater for a bad movie. But this one, we're like, dude, this is good. We're like, this is going to be terrible. Let's go pay for it. And we did, and I'm gonna let Kelly take over.
So, now, to add on to that, paying for that movie, I realized when we got there that I actually had a coupon for a free movie, and I could not work up the courage and face the embarrassment of giving that coupon to the woman up front and saying, yeah, I'd like to use my free coupon.
One for Bucky Larson, please.
Yeah, I would say like that, too. So, I decided to buy my ticket. That way I wouldn't have to look at anybody while I was purchasing this thing. So, we go in there. There's maybe a couple of other random people in there. They're raiding Drew's fridge, by the way, as I'm explaining this.
It's okay. Scott's being a dink.
I had some milk.
I already called you a dink on this podcast.
Okay, fine. Well, then Scott's being... vagina.
Alright.
I couldn't think of anything clever or... Anyways, can I please? I'd like to interrupt.
Yeah, there's a few scattered people around and what have you, and the movie starts. My God, it was just terrible. And there is one redeeming quality about it.
And that was...
It was?
Maybe not redeeming, but just, like, one somewhat enjoyable quality, which was Kevin Nealon just being a complete psychopath.
Oh, yes.
Because... He's drinking my fucking Dr. Pepper, isn't he? What's he doing?
He's touching himself.
Oh, he's getting warm.
Okay.
You different than any other night.
You don't want a beer.
No, I don't want a beer.
Break edge.
I'm not breaking edge.
I don't want
a Martina Navratilovsky.
Don't start with that bullshit. So, yeah, Kevin Nealon was funny because he was just, like, I swear to God.
I don't think he was asked to be in the movie.
He was. I think he just shut up one day and was like, all right, I'm going to be in this movie.
Everybody else.
Exactly. So I think Adam Sandler was like, oh, yeah, I just let him do whatever he wants. So that was, I guess, somewhat funny. But the rest of the movie just fucking, it was so bad that I slid out of my seat and onto the floor in complete ire and malice.
Much to the delight of me and Justin.
Yes.
That just further enhanced our bad movie-going experience.
And like, we could have written the entire evening off, but Kelly writhing on the floor in physical pain over the sheer horridness of this movie made it somewhat redeeming for Scott and myself.
It was a win.
And so, in like, the plot of the story is, you know, him trying to become, like, a porn star because his mom and dad were porn stars or something like that. And I don't remember, like, kind of the other point of him wanting to become one. I think he just wanted people to like him or something like that.
I guess he needed a purpose, and he got really excited when he found out his parents were porn stars, basically.
So,
and he's a dummy from the Midwest. With silly teeth and the world's smallest dick.
Yeah. All good now, stuff. That's the plot. Side plot.
Oh, man.
Oh.
Made me...
I've seen some B-plots in my time. This was a winner.
Holy shit. I wanted to headbutt a kitten when I saw this. Oh. Is it Christina Ricci?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Again, looks very young in this film. Very thin, too. Like...
Like, not well.
No, yeah. This and...
Post-boob reduction, I believe?
Yes.
What? Why?
I don't know.
They're too big.
Hurt her back.
Back problems.
All right.
Falling down a lot.
Yeah.
Whoops.
Falling into cakes.
Yeah.
But she works as a waitress, and she befriends him and stuff like that. And her dream, this was her dream in the film, her dream job.
Someone asked her, if you could do anything in life, what would you do?
She wanted to waitress at, like, a fancy Italian restaurant.
And what was she doing now?
She was waitressing at some crummy...
At a not fancy restaurant.
A crummy diner or something like that. So that was her dream to be
a waitress. Her dream was to do the same shitty thing somewhere else.
Now, why couldn't she achieve her dream?
Oh, my God.
For hilarious reasons. Kelly's reliving past traumas right now.
He's in numb right now.
She could not live her dream because when she was a waitress in her younger days, she accidentally spilled a tray of hot soup on an old lady and scalded her. So
now she got the jimmies.
Now she can't handle hot soup.
Nope.
That's why she can't complete her dream because she's afraid to carry hot soup. So what does Bucky do? I'm going to help you get over your fear. And the side, like, part of the movie is him, like, teaching you how to walk around, like, obstacles with a tray in her hand, and, like, he'll use, like, prop soup.
Dear God, please tell me there is a scene with her balancing books on her head.
Probably!
I think there was.
I'm more than certain there was.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there was. You haven't seen this, right, Drew?
I have not seen it, and Drew, I don't think I ever will.
No, Drew, you are missing out on a vital part of life.
Okay, well, maybe I'll see it with you guys again. So,
recommended.
In a theater?
Yeah, when it gets re-released.
When it gets re-released in 3D.
With extended footage and upgraded graphics.
So, my head hurts right now, so I'm not even going to talk about it anymore.
Okay, well... I haven't seen that, so I can't add anything to it, but on the topic of movies that nobody has seen, I don't know if you guys have seen a trailer for this movie. I am really fucking excited for it. It is the new Quentin Tarantino project.
Which one?
That is written, directed by and starring the RZA.
What?
It is called The Man with the Iron Fists. Mm-hmm. And it is, like...
I'll tell you, it's a movie about Jax from Mortal Kombat.
Actually, it is a straight-up kung fu movie.
Yeah.
Filmed by the two of them, and it has... Well, first of all, one of the main characters is Russell Crowe.
Great. Whoa. Well, he's fighting around the world.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's Russell Crowe, it's Lucy Liu, Pam Grier, and the main villain, and not it's not just, like, a small role with no lines, and he's just, like, a guy... is a former WWE superstar and champion, Dave Bautista.
Wow.
But yeah, look, it actually looks really good.
I was Tarantino's, like, producing?
He co-wrote it with RZA, and okay. He's a producer. But it actually, like, Razor. For the silliness of it and the fact that it's Russell Crowe in a kung fu movie, it actually looks pretty cool. Like, it's very... Because it's... Tarantino, right?
Yeah.
So it's very visual, lots of cool costumes and weaponry.
But I guess it blows the load over all the Shaw Brothers movies he watched when he was a kid.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, so, but the, it actually looks really good, so people...
Quentin Tarantino, big fanboy or biggest fanboy?
biggest, absolutely, but... Yeah, so people...
Just a nerd who gets to make movies! Oh, yeah. It's not fair!
Yeah.
Good to be us.
I will show you guys the trailer once we're done recording, but people out there should check out the trailer because it actually, I'm pretty excited for it. So
I can't wait to own a RZA action figure.
Very from good. This movie?
Why from the G.I. Joe movie.
Why didn't she get me why didn't she get me a Fumbles figure?
Fumbles.
That's Dr. Fumbles.
Scouser Snake.
No, I have a PhD, and you call me a Dr. Killshot or Trigger Man. Or did you hear that, everybody? It's Dr. Fumbles. Guess we should cancel. Who's going to fuck the new guy count?
When's the new G.I. Joe coming out now? 2015? 17?
How mad?
2020.
How mad are you? How many tables did you flip when you found that out?
Oh, a dozen.
How many sinks did you rip out of the wall?
It says that it is coming out...
Never.
August 2013.
Just canceled?
Well, sure.
But what happens if Hasbro puts out another piece of shit in spring 2013? Then do we move G.I. Joe again?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Is we filmed in 4D?
Did you
when Hasbro puts out Hungry Hungry Hippos in April 2013.
That's a Milton Brothers property, fuck you.
Oh man, I have been told not once but twice.
Did you hear how Doug was saying how he's mad that Kerplunk didn't get changed?
Kerplunk is a great game.
Why did they hold back G.I. Joe for
Battleship? They claimed they wanted to refilm it in 3D and to refilm parts with Channing Tatum because of his popularity due to 21 Jump Street. But the real reason is because Battleship tanked, which was a Hasbro property,
And the Paramount
John
property.
Carter tanked because it was a Paramount property.
Yeah. And if G.I. Joe tanks, Paramount goes out of business.
Now... Isn't Channing Tatum one of the main characters in that film?
Yeah, but he dies pretty quickly, apparently.
Oh.
And he didn't take his shirt off enough.
I guess.
So we gotta fix that.
Yep.
Both valid reasons.
Now, are they killing off all the characters because they want to do what they did with the Transformers movie? The cartoon one? And, like, reintroduce new characters to make more fun?
Kind of. Also, to divorce itself from the awful first movie.
Yeah. Although, did you like it?
Not really. I liked it as an action movie. I didn't like it as a G.I. Joe movie.
You liked it because it was G.I. Joe, but then found out that it was terrible?
I wanted to like it.
Yeah. I wanted to like it too, but I did not.
Yeah, that's fair. Oh, God.
It's calling me. I didn't see it because I thought it was a Pixar movie.
Yeah, so is there anything else? Or I think we've gone probably...
We're probably good.
2 hours? Pretty close to 2 hours?
I don't know.
I don't want to touch the phone because I don't want it to stop recording.
No, me either. We'll deal with that when it's over. But, yeah, hopefully this sounds better. I think it will.
It should. I did a test recording and it sounded a lot better.
Okay. I hope it doesn't sound like four muted trombones. But, yeah, it'd be nice if we, even if we're just a little bit under an hour 30, just so we are going in the right direction as far as
length. To be fair, we could probably crop out a couple of these games and make them into, like, Easter eggs or something.
I feel like that would take more work.
Can we film an episode where we are all auto-tuned?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
So?
I guess...
Anyone have anything to plug?
I plug my Twitter, but I guess nobody listened to show two because I have no new followers.
Zero new followers.
I plug it again.
Plug it again.
I'm going to go ahead.
Drew Sarian.
At Drew Sarian.
You add me, and then I give you a hand job.
If you can't remember Sarian, think of it as a combination between early TNA X Division superstars Chris Sabin and Frankie Kazarian. Sabin Kazarian. Sarian.
Or
Drew Sarian.
Or just think of it as Drew, which is a shortened version of my first name. And then
Drew
S, which is the letter for my real last name. And Arian, because I support white power.
Oh, also good.
I'm going to take this moment to go and plug Drew's toilet.
Hey! That's Kelly's job.
Yeah, Kelly's got the monopoly on ruining
Kelly,
the
you already did your plug, so you get...
Yeah, sure.
I already did my plug and my shit in.
Yeah,
so you can
plug. Yeah, you got the whole thing.
You can plug, get anything plug.
You
should get on Twitter so that new followers won't follow you as well.
That sounds like
although you have a lot of fanboys, so you might get a lot more followers.
You'll probably get all the followers.
That sounds exciting.
They all follow me, but that was probably because they couldn't follow Scott. So Scott joins, follow Scott, and then they unfollow me.
Yes. So you're getting on my Twitter heat right now, eh?
Yeah.
Well, let's keep it that way, because Twitter fucking sucks. I have nothing new to plug. More information as events warrant. Justin, anything to plug?
You have a Twitter? Aside from the toilet?
Yeah.
Aside from the toilet? No. You have a Twitter? Do you care to plug it? What's your Twitter?
You can all follow me if you want. ChooChoo33.
ChooChoo33. C-H-U-C-H-U-3-3.
Ow. If you're listening to this, you probably already follow me, so that's fine.
It's entirely possible. We are preaching to the converted
here. Yes. Okay, well, so all you random YouTubers out there, please feel free to follow us.
Yeah, for sure. Who stumble on this... undoubtedly by accident.
Well, maybe somebody's looking
and then and then listen to the end. Good for you.
Well, maybe they're looking for Zach Galifianakis comedy and ours comes up.
Yeah.
Or maybe they're looking for gay porn. I don't know why they're looking for gay porn on YouTube.
Either way, we're so sorry we disappointed you.
I feel like if it was a random listener, they should get a prize for having sat through all that bullshit. Yeah.
If you randomly listen to this entire thing, add me on Twitter, send me a message, and I will send you one of my copies of Caligula as a prize.
that's pretty good. That is pretty good. Come on, people. That's worth something. All right, so with that in mind, with that at the top of your heads, until next time.
Nick Price's knee is a shithead.
What am I supposed to say here?
Oh, yeah, you're new at this.
What, somebody, a person, a thing.
Either something you legitimately think is a shithead, or something that you think would never be called a shithead, so it's funny that way.
Kofi Annan is a shithead.
And Kevin Nealon is a shithead. See you next time.